Hi, my name is Ron Lohman. I'm here with my colleague, Rich Collins. And today we're going to talk about AI compute needs. And so, Rich, over the last 5 years, we've seen a ton of changes with respect to the type of math that's required because of AI. What are the basic building blocks required for this type of processing? And what do you see that your portfolios have to do?
Right. If you look at things, multiple accumulators or MACs are kind of dominating the semiconductor landscape now. Tensor math has enabled computers to outpace human identification accuracy. So depending on the complexity required, this may be serviced by either dedicated DSPs or may require additional hardware acceleration. If you look at that from an implementation perspective, many processors are capable of executing single MAC instructions, but dot product style, 8x16 or 16x16 dual and quad MAC instructions increase parallelism and obviously the processing that's required to manage that. These are executable in things that we've focused on in our latest ARC processors, where we've combined both RISC and DSP processing into a single architecture.
Okay. And Synopsys does have a portfolio of foundation IP building blocks like floating point dot product hardware. And customers use those for their accelerators. But from an ARC portfolio perspective, how has the architecture changed specifically beyond the MAC parallelism? And what does an ARC portfolio provide in addition to what a build your own may give you?
Right. So as I mentioned, standard RISC architectures have added this combination of multiply MAC operations to increase the number of MACs that can be executed per cycle. But if you look at it in terms of the workloads that are being demanded, more work per cycle is a key differentiation that we try to address in the ARC portfolio. So combining this RISC plus DSP into a single programmable processor can address a pretty broad range of machine learning applications and algorithms.
And with AI math basically being computed in every new type of SoC across the board from Synopsys' perspective, we see a lot of 32-bit floating point, 16-bit, 8-bit. What do you foresee in the future that processors really have to handle with respect to AI?
Yeah, I think it's real clear that neural frameworks like TensorFlow and their support for 8-bit quantization have really standardized these architectures, especially for real-time applications. And to that end, the INT8 MACs are really becoming the most prevalent architectural choice across the board. So now, when you look at architectural comparisons, there's more level playing field. There's more of an apples to apples comparison. You can look at things like inferences per second if you're talking about performance, or you can look at inferences per joule if you're talking about power analysis. We will probably see a migration to smaller architectures such as 4-bit, but at least for now, INT8 is very much prevalent. So that's kind of on the processing side. Overall, we're seeing that future architectures are going to adapt new activation features, things like non-linearity functionality in a graph like MobileNet V3, or new types of neural networks altogether. And one in particular that we're starting to see a lot of traction is this idea of transformers, deep learning models that are simpler in structure and easier to train. They're largely used in natural language processing today, but there is a migration to push this into the embedded edge devices and be able to broaden the number of domains that can be supported, like vision processing.
Yeah, and clearly those models such as transformers are getting more and more complex every day. So is there anything else that you wanted to mention from Synopsys and the portfolio solutions they have for AI today?
Just in general, our focus is to try and provide kind of a seamless solution, a common SDK, for instance, that can cover the applications from the lowest end that would use an ARC EM type class of core, all the way up to what we have for our dedicated embedded vision processors and neural processing units that can manage some of the more complex machine learning types of tasks.
Okay. Well, I appreciate your time and your expertise today. And if you want to learn more, you can go to synopsys.com. Thank you.